There are times Juliana's mother thinks of giving her up. Maybe someone else can give her four-year-old a good life. It's unthinkable. But what do you do when you have nothing, when you would do anything to protect your child? A few months ago, the single mother was making just about enough to pay rent and feed her daughter. But since the coronavirus lockdown, Aya's had no work. She hasn't been able to pay rent in 2 months and is now facing eviction. She slept on the streets back home in Ethiopia and here in Beirut. The thought of her daughter being homeless keeps her up at night. Since my childhood, I've had a very bad life, she says. I don't want my daughter to have the same life that I've had. Like Aya, an estimated 250,000 migrant women, most from Ethiopia, came to Lebanon to be housemaids, making as little as $150 US a month. Many have endured years of abuse and exploitation, but they've experienced nothing like what they're going through right now. The coronavirus lockdown hit an economy already on the verge of collapse, and now most Lebanese can no longer afford domestic workers, leaving thousands of migrant women jobless and penniless.
They are a strong woman and helping their family, taking care of their family, and paying the education, building a house. Those women don't have even food on the table, and they are asking for help to feed their kids and to live, to survive.
Yimer set up her group to empower Ethiopian domestic workers. Now her volunteers are working around the clock to feed them, relying on donations through crowdfunding. Every day, the list of those in need is growing.
The situation is terrible.
The anti-racism movement, an advocacy group defending the rights of migrant workers in Lebanon, is now, for the first time ever, having to do relief work, distributing food supplies to 2,000 people a month. But so many need more than food to survive.
This sheltering of cases that were just thrown out of their employer's house against their will, and who are now literally stranded on the streets with all the official shelters being closed or full because of the corona crisis, with their embassies and consulates being non-responsive, and we literally have no place to put these people.
Some are already sleeping on the streets. With news of repatriation flights resuming, there's a desperate wait outside the Ethiopian consulate. Some have been here for days. They just want to go home. But even that comes with a price tag most can't afford. More than $1,000 for a plane ticket and their government's mandatory 14-day quarantine, leaving them trapped in this limbo, stranded and alone. Jomana Karadsheh, CNN.